Welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect 2 Blind. I am the RPG chick. We're gonna finish exploring the Crescent Nebula. We have one more system to look at. And that is Andeste, I believe. Okay, small system. There's only three planets here. Zesmeni. Cold, dim, and shrouded by a methane ammonia atmosphere, Zesmeni has nevertheless attracted development by Asari mining concerns that service military industries. There are significant loads of valuable light metals present, including titanium and lithium. Titanium is the primary material used in mass accelerator slugs, and lithium is used in the military-grade droplet heat radiators used aboard warships. Population is 620. Oh my god, the temperature though. Rich. In, what'd they say? Platinum? We really don't need anything but element zero. I am not pressing left mouse, game. Interesting planet. Okay, so now we have this platinum-rich planet that we researched. Pretty sure it's in the merchant area of Ilium. If not, then on the Shadowbroker base, vessel, whatever. Icaria. Though nearly the size of Earth, Icaria contains only 28% of its mass. It has a trace atmosphere of neon and molecular nitrogen, but the predominant carbon dioxide has long since frozen and fallen to the surface as frost. While Icaria has a core of heavy metals, the bulk of the planet's volume consists of water ice. Several unique forms of long-chain carbon molecules have been recovered on the surface, pushed up from beneath the ice by cryovolcanic processes. Icaria has a large rocky moon, compositionally similar to Luna. Rich. Yeah, we don't need any of this stuff, unfortunately. Okay, we're good. One more planet. See if there's anything that see in this planet. System, rather. Farthest from the dim red dwarf Andeste, the ice dwarf Maesuth has attracted no interest beyond a cursory flyby by automated probe in 1874. No significant resources were noted. Nothing going on in this system, huh? It's a really out-of-the-way system in the cluster as well. As far as, in relation to the, mass relay and all that. That's it. Wow, we were done with this system fast, and I thought we would be. Or cluster, rather. 100% explored. Okay. Well, that was quick. Let us, fuel up and head to the mass relay. On to the next.
Only half our fuel remains.
Oh, okay, we're here. Hold your horses. Time to move on. Yeah. Let's go to the Shrike Abyssal. He's head towards the place where we need to destroy the Blood Pack base. I don't know if we'll do it this episode. I might just look at other systems. Zecha. That's where the Blood Pack base is. Hey, might as well. Gonna go explore the other systems first. Planets, that is. Vem Oska, a Jovian gas giant. Vem Oska, weeping witness in Imperian Volus, is a low-density hydrogen-helium planet with 35 moons. Later this year, 33 of the moons will be visible from the planet's surface in conjunction, an event that will be recorded by space probes from all over the galaxy. Neat. Again, we only need element zero. We have so much of everything else. And we don't find element zero that often, so we're gonna be saving a lot of probes. The fuel depot is this one. Tossal Nim. The sister tragedy to the extinction event on Aphras, Tossal Nim was the rarest of jewels, a second garden planet within the same life zone as Aphras. Not as old as its sister planet, its fossil evidence indicates it was home to abundant invertebrate sea life. However, similar craters of those on Aphras created a dust cloud, shroud rather, that killed 99% of biota on the planet. The even spacing of the craters indicates a coordinated simultaneous attack from points around the globe rather than an asteroid collision or supervolcanic scenario. I thought I saw a little element zero. No. Wishful thinking. Wait, I see it now. Nice. It's over here.
Probe launched.
Here's some more. Yay.
Away.
Wow, we're really getting a nice amount of element zero now. Nice, right on it.
Probe away.
Oh, awesome.
Launching probe.
I'm not completely sure if we've ever had this much element zero before. Just gonna check over it again. Seems to be easy to miss. Like they're only small areas. Okay, we're good. Aphras. A unique discovery, Aphras is a heavenly twin, a planet in a star system that is not one but two worlds of sufficient mass to retain a nitrogen-oxygen atmosphere within the habitable life zone of its parent star. Fossil evidence shows abundant vertebrates and evidence of a sapient terrestrial avian species in its Bronze Age. However, the only trace of contemporary life on the planet is that of a single-celled organisms in the seas. All else has suffered from an extinction event, a series of massive impacts that vaporized vast quantities of water and lofted dust into its atmosphere. Early theories that this event was a collision with a fragmenting asteroid have now been discounted. The impact craters were aimed directly at habitation centers. Oh, wow. It was purposeful. Checking quick for element zero. Nope. Okay. Zada Ban. Anomaly detected. Scans show a crude base established on a planet's surface. Communications match known Blood Pact mercenary protocols. Numerous life signs matching Vorcha genealogy detected. The base's material resources match our data on weapons manufacturing components. I almost hit land by mistake. I don't get a description of the planet. Oh wait. Ooh. Nice.
Probe away.
I was expecting that. I got so excited.
Launched.
Let's see. Any more? There we go. It's really easy to miss, it seems.
Probe.
Wow, over 20,000 ESO, that's a lot for that. Okay, we are good. So we're not gonna get a listing of the planet. Guess not. Maybe if I leave when we're done with the mission and come back. Then. Vorcha. I went with someone with some cool powers. Let's take Grunt and Jack. Grunt can't use any. Jack, however. Let's give her pull mastery. Pull field. You know what? I'll give her heavy pull. That's all we can do there. Let's go kill some black metal dudes.
I am detecting a large power source inside the base. It is probable that destroying it would disrupt the entire facility.
Cool. Sounds good. There's a data pad to read. Kalusk! Heh! These guys again. You'll get your resources when they're good and ready. You want to come mine these rocks yourself? Everything will be ready for the attack. If you'd gotten me the additional Vorcha I asked for, it would have been done by now. Salam Yul. Yeah, huh? Anything else around here? Oh. I can't... That was funny. Oh, man. Let's save before I get stuck on anything else. I hear them. Kalusk, I'm sending back two of the Vorcha you sent me so that you can see what I'm dealing with out here. I suggest you not arm these morons. These piss-poor shots are more likely to blast the broadside of one of your generators than hit their intended targets. Maybe once you understand what I'm dealing with, you won't be so quick to mock me when I ask for some goddamn assistance. Salam Yul. Here's some palladium. 600, to be exact. Now, where do we go from here? How do we get down? This way. Can't save. Enemies nearby.
You're up!
The other guy. Oh.
Worthless.
Down there, huh? Switch to concussive. I mean incendiary.
Come here!
I'll put them down!
Oh, they jumped down there. Okay. Well, let me look around up here. Well, they ran down there. And then came back up. Well, thanks, guys. You really are a lot more fearless than I am. Stuff. 600 palladium. Kalusk, some of my Vorcha have gone missing. I need more if you expect us to get this work done on schedule. I don't care how you get them. Ask Garm for his extras. He has to have some cast-offs that are good enough for mining duty. Salam Yul. Salam Yul. Oh, Salam Yul. Oh, yeah, I see.
One down.
Oh, there's dudes up there too. Gotcha.
destroy you!
And I'll help her. Can't really see him.
Watch the landing.
Guy was like floating or something. Yeah. Hi. What's this say? I cannot read. I cannot read that. Obviously, we're going that way. Special door. Anything else? Nope. Into the hive we go. I am near explosives.
Fire! Fire!
Containment zone?
I'll put them down!
Step up! Nothing can stop us!
It's Kalusk! Ow.
They're through my shields!
Bye, Kalusk. That's something you got. Someone got you down off your high, lofty cloud there. Whatever the hell I'm talking about. Looking for rounds.
Take a look at that.
Yeah. Hey, palladium. 800 of it. Too bad I didn't see them near this explosive stuff. I saw my friends near the containment cells. I didn't want to shoot that. No rounds. We got it's around here. Not much at all. Very pretty though. Is this where it came from? Oh god, we went back. No. I don't want to go there. I went all the way back. Are we supposed to go through here? yes. Something. This is that ramp that just goes back down. Wait. Alright, there must be something through here then. Or not. Sorry, guys. I don't know where to go. Am I supposed to destroy these or something? Does that finish the mission? Well, let me see. I'm supposed to destroy them.
We need to leave.
Evacuate? Okay. Cool. Okay. I didn't know we were supposed to do that. I thought it was just stuff to hit during combat.
This looks interesting.
Fromage Blood Pack Weapons Production Facility. Decimated Blood Pack Vorcha Soldiers. 125 experience. 45% heavy weapon ammo capacity. 7,500 credits. 2,000 palladium. And done. Okay. We'll do our research. Any messages?
No messages for you, Commander.
Thank you. You figured this would be under weapons. Okay, plus 45% heavy weapon ammo capacity. That's pretty good. M920 Keen. Ooh, new heavy weapon. The effectiveness and efficiency of Mass Effect-based weapon technology has rendered large-scale deployment of highly explosive weaponry all but obsolete in infantry weapons. Normandy scientists have prototyped a modified version of traditional high-explosive rounds that is applied to a 25-gram slug. When accelerated to 5 kilometers per second, the round is devastating. Although a technically inaccurate label, this prototype weapon is nicknamed the Nuke Launcher. Cool. And its high explosive matrix generates an archetypical mushroom cloud on impact. I like that. Inflicts high damage with a large area of effect. Very effective against armor, shields, and barriers. Effective against anything. Taking it. Add it to the armory. thing's blinking. Curious for a sign off for the episode. How many more systems? Apparently, just one more. Yeah, nothing else. Okay, so next episode we will explore the second out of two systems in the Shrike Abyssal, and then we'll be heading on to the next one. Thanks so much for watching, see you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.